nothing but a couple of nerds going to Rhode Island Comic Con today. Let's get it done.
Jon's Adventure Vlog.
Hello and welcome to Jon's Adventure Vlog. Jon Paula here, inside Rhode Island's Convention Center for Rhode Island Comic Con, which already only been here for 35 seconds. Substantially better than that shitty Creation Entertainment Star Trek that we went to at the Heinz Convention Center earlier this year. And how much more did we pay for that? $170 more. Wow, this looks fun. There's people here. I'm already having a good time. I brought my Back to the Future hoverboard with me, and I gotta say, just having that in my backpack makes me feel like a badass. I'm gonna hopefully get it signed by James Tolkan and Claudia Wells. Dude, Kim Raver, did you hear she got signed on for the new 24 thing? It has wheels on it.
Yeah.
Just like the real one. They have a scale replica of the Rancor, a full-size replica of Jabba the Hutt, land speeders, stormtroopers, TIE fighter pilots. As a Star Wars nerd, this is a joy. We came here straight from the Red Sox parade. And I have to wonder how many other people here do the exact same thing. Wake up early, go to the parade, cheer on David Ortiz and the Red Sox, and then drive straight down 95 South to see the Rhode Island Comic Con convention. I'm guessing the overlap between sports fans and comic book nerds is not a very big slice in that Venn diagram, but I'm happy to support both groups today. Red Sox, nerds, you're both awesome. You got the Blue Ranger over. I know you weren't in the second movie.
I'll sign it anyway.
But I want to get like most of the cast as I can to sign it.
It's heavy.
Yeah, it is heavy. It doesn't actually hover. That's kind of why. Wait, why is there not a gigantic line for Danny Glover? This man is a national treasure. Danny Glover is 10 feet away. Are you excited?
Hey, may I shake your hand, Mr. Glover?
Yes, sir.
Pleasure to meet you. Big fan.
So just had an opportunity to meet James Tolkan of Back to the Future fame, Principal Strickland, and Claudia Wells. Totally nice people. I got them both to sign my hoverboard. Now, I've never been to like one of the West Coast Comic Cons or like big ones in Vegas, San Diego, or LA. So for me, this is like my only real taste of like a big costume-oriented convention. I gotta say, I've been impressed with a lot of these things. Realistic looking Echo Packs. Girl over there, they just had a piranha plant for Mario made out of balloons. Some really inventive, clever, and screen authentic costumes. So I have to give it up to these folks.
Random!
He wants to take you for a drive.
What's up, Mr. Ramos? Just look out for Jon Amos. He's like 9 feet tall.
Admiral Fitzwallace.
I couldn't help but notice you mentioned on the phone something about the new. You're going to be on the new 24, right?
No, we don't know.
Okay, pleasure to meet you. Always love hearing your voice in my Call of Duty game.
And do I bark orders at you and tell you to straighten up and fly right?
Right, exactly. Yeah. The versatile Glenn Morshower was basically totally awesome. Took like a dozen photos with us, signed a whole poem on Riley's 8x10, and told us a bunch of stories about the new 24 series, his work on Call of Duty, and it was great. So we've been in and out of the artist illustration aisles now, taking a look at all the artwork. This is, after all, a comic book convention, I have to say. Don't recognize any of the names or much of the artwork, but they're all very talented. There's some good stuff. Stuff you can even hang on your living room wall, maybe. How are you today, sir?
This is you.
Doing good?
So far, so good. And you?
Good. Nice to meet you. We just met up with some folks that work with the Team Fox crew and got to hang out in and around a 99.9% screen accurate replica of the Mark 1 time machine from Back to the Future.
When he says 99.9, he literally means like 99.
Like the time circuits work, the flux capacitor fluxes.
It looks like Tony Stark's reactor.
Yeah.
It goes on in sync with the rest of the car.
Now, what occurs to me, I don't know that Doc has ever sat in the passenger seat of this in the movies.
Only in the video game.
That doesn't actually suck into the... What?
No. That's great.
All right, we're lead line, guys. Yeah. You can take the Devo suits off.
This is street legal.
Yeah.
They will shoot CO2.
If you, yeah.
And that's street legal also? That seems like Batmobile shit.
Not exactly.
They also have the Libyans fucking VW microbus. They got license plates from the actual movie. They got a wax figure of Doc and Marty, Einstein the dog, the watches, the remote controls, the Mr. Fusion, the Almanac. I was in nerd heaven. Back to the Future is my all-time favorite film ever. And that was Pokemon. Like just a little mecca of all of that awesome in one space. You enjoyed it. Good time. You come back.
Three like million times better than Creation's Entertainment.
Even the costumes were pretty good.
Stormtroopers.
And all the celebrities were all really nice.
Super nice. Super nice.
I had a good time. There were a bunch of panels, but we didn't go to any of them. Mostly because they were reunions and stuff for shows and movies we haven't seen yet. Relaxing after a very long day, the parade, the convention, been on my feet the whole time. It is time to go home though. So after our quick little massage here, that we'll have to do for this episode of Jon's Adventure Vlog. Thank you for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.